Good afternoon. I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to speak on this topic, FECO emulsification, a must for residents. I have no financial interest. Why knowing FECO emulsification is a must for residents? Because it is a part of the basic teaching curriculum. As a postgraduate in ophthalmology, the resident is expected to know the basic cataract surgery, and that is FECO emulsification. And it is a basic skill one should acquire as an ophthalmologist because it is one of the most fundamental eye surgeries. And as far as job prospect is concerned, when after finishing your graduation, when you go for job interview, this is what a resident is asked. When he's job hunting, can you do FECO emulsification? How many FECO surgeries have you done? Are you comfortable doing FECO? These days, even during our DNB exams, these questions are asked by the examiner. And there are certain demerits of manual SICS over FECO emulsification. There is conjunctival congestion which persists for 5 to 7 days at the site of the conjunctival flap. Mild tenderness sometimes may present owing to the scleral incision. Postoperative hyphema may be noted sometimes. Surgical induced astigmatism is more as the incision in SICS is large, about 6 mm as compared to FECO, which is only about 2.8 mm. Other demerits of FECO emulsification over manual SICS is it is a small incision size, and whereas in SICS it is 6 to 7 mm incision, in FECO it is 2.2 to 2.8 mm incision. And other merits include reduced surgically induced astigmatism and good unaided visual acuity. And we already know that surgically induced astigmatism is proportional to the size of the incision. In a study conducted by George et al., they found that the mean surgical induced astigmatism was 1.17 diopters for the SICS group and 0.77 diopters for the FECO emulsification group with a significant p-value of 0.001. Other merits of FECO over manual SICS include sutureless with good wound strength and integrity and reduced endothelial cell loss as it is performed in the posterior chamber and there is no prolapsing of the nucleus into the anterior chamber, and also reduced postoperative endophthalmitis. It has been found that use of injectable IOLs with small incision FECO emulsification reduced the risk of endophthalmitis and also the patient's recovery time is reduced. The government in Chile has mandated FECO for cataract surgery in the state-run health system since 2004. And after doing FECO, patients can return to their normal life in a few days and recover their vision faster. And last but not the least, this can also be done under topical anesthesia. With this, I conclude that knowing FECO emulsification is a must for residents because that is the surgery which is in today's world, people should know as an ophthalmologist. When I was a student, it was ICC, intracapsular cataract extraction and extracapsular cataract extraction. Now it is FECO emulsification, and we will be blamed if we are not going to teach our students FECO emulsification. Because once they go out and when people ask, do you know FECO? And if they say no, they will cut a very sorry figure, not only for themselves, but also the institutions from which they are trained. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Magdalene. Dr. Dhrubajyoti is there to oppose the motion.